So now we're going to walk you through a whole bunch of special matrices and talk about what the inverse matrices of those matrices are. And what you're going to see is that there's a pattern of how you should think about this. This particular video is cut up into many pieces because we're going to interleave it with homework exercises so that you can practice this as we go along. Math is not a spectator sport. So here is the general principle. If you're given a matrix A, what you want to do is check whether A is square, because a linear transformation can only be a bijection if it goes from Rn to Rn, and therefore only a matrix that is square can be invertible. The next thing you do is you ask yourself, what is the matrix that undoes A of x? After all, we know that whatever matrix you come up with has to have the property that it undoes what matrix A did. And sometimes, by just thinking about it, you can determine what that matrix is. And if so, you can save yourself a lot of time, and more importantly, you really gain a lot of insight about what the inverse is by thinking about this deeply. So you guess, okay? And you call that result matrix B, and what you can then do is check that indeed B times A is the identity and A times B is the identity. Now, often you can't guess, or the problem is complex enough that you need a more methodical approach to computing the inverse. And that methodical approach we're going to discuss next week. So, do the exercises and watch the videos that interleave with the exercises. So here's the first exercise. Go and do it, and I'll see you in the next video.